Bringing a life into this world is a very joyous and wonderful experience, but it also brings about many body changes which may revert with time and exercise and diet, but some changes may not. Hello friends, I'm Dr. Deeksha Dixit, a cosmetic surgeon based in Delhi and director and co-founder of the Esculpit Clinic at GK1 in New Delhi. So today, I will be talking about a set of procedure which is comprehensively called as Mommy Makeover. Mommy Makeover is a set of procedure which is customized according to the need of the patient and the part which she needs to restore or enhance. So based on one's unique cosmetic goals, these procedures chiefly addresses your breast, your tummy, your waist, your thighs, buttocks and vaginas, and that is the genitals. It also sometimes include facial rejuvenation depending on the part or depending on whether the patient wants to restore or enhance the facial look as well. What are the common issues which we see or the patient faces after pregnancy? So starting with the breast, there is usually drooping of breast. The breast droops down and it becomes lax and less voluminous. Then there is stubborn deposition of fat in the belly area, thigh area, back areas, and there is also excess skin chiefly in the lower part of your abdomen and back as well. And along with that, there might be vaginal laxity. So Mommy Makeover takes care of all these issues. For breast, we have breast augmentation or enhancement or breast lift. To enhance the waist or contour the thigh or the belly area, we have liposuction. And if there is, along with excess fat, there is excess skin hanging, which is loose and hanging, it can be taken care of by tummy tuck. For vaginal laxity, vaginal rejuvenation procedures are also advised. Along with that, if you have facial dullness or you think your skin has laxed over time and it is not looking fresh, there are other facial rejuvenation procedures which we can include in Mommy Makeover. Many females come to us post-pregnancy because they feel depressed about the way they look and the body changes are not reversed with their extreme exercise and diet even. So what are the benefits of Mommy Makeover? Mommy Makeover not only increases your self-confidence and your self-image, since you are down with your excess fat and your excess skin, you are able to fit in better into your desired clothes. Along with that, there is an increased energy level to do your physical activities because there is a lot of functional improvement. The excess skin between your thighs or in your belly, which is removed after Mommy Makeover, enhances or improves your functional activity. Apart from this, you develop a positive outlook towards life in doing things. Whether or not you are a candidate for Mommy Makeover or not, it is very important to have a discussion or consultation with your plastic surgeon to know whether you are a candidate for Mommy Makeover or not. An ideal candidate are those who are in good general health, have completed their family, are at near normal ideal weight according to their height, have a stable weight for 6 months or more, they are not heavy smokers, and they have realistic expectations. If you are planning to go for specific breast surgeries, it is important that you are non-lactating at that time. Once you plan for a Mommy Makeover, it is very important to have a detailed discussion with your expert so that you can prioritize your concerned areas. Now, when you are trying to go for a Mommy Makeover, it is very important to know the stages in which all your Mommy Makeover procedures will be completed. Since it is a staged procedure, you should address your main concerns first and then prioritize your other procedures accordingly. For this, your expert will help you. After that, it is very important for you to know that you have to quit smoking at least 7 to 10 days prior to your procedures. You should not be on blood thinners at least a week before surgery, and you should be properly hydrated before your surgery. Now, what to expect post-operatively after your surgery? Depending on the type of surgeries, you will be given specific precautions to follow post-operatively. But generally, you are advised rest for some hours and then you have to be ambulatory as soon as possible and increase your ambulation with time and with days. You can resume your normal work in about 7 to 10 days depending upon how you fare post-operatively. In general, you have to drink a lot of fluids to keep yourself hydrated and should be on good protein diet. Apart from this, in general, heavy weight lifting or doing heavy exercises are to be avoided for about 3 weeks. Smoking and drinking are prohibited or avoided for at least 2 weeks post-operatively so that your scar heals well and your body is adapted to your new body change. Hope you find this video useful. If you have any queries regarding this procedure or any other details you want to know, please drop your questions in our comment box, and also subscribe to our channel for any further details. Thank you.